See, first, let us go through with the demonstration how it works and how we can. In the previous lab, we were able to create the front end, right? This option is number one and number two. These two are the edit text views, and remaining these are the buttons. Okay. So, based on the value, if you are going to use, suppose 50, the number is 50, and another number is like, for example, 70.53. So, addition of this, addition of that is emulator. I will change the emulator from Nexus to Pixel. Okay, so type the value 20 and so 70.85, some value. Click on plus. See, the output is visible on the same screen. If you click on the arithmetic operation minus, it is a simple calculator. You are developing a simple calculator using the Android Studio. So minus, multiplication and division. If the second number is zero in case of division, what it should display? Infinity, that is divide by zero, right? So validation and designing the screen. In the previous lab, we have designed the calculator, right? Are you able to code the design screen? In the previous lab itself, we have done this one. You want me to repeat this designing? Yes, you want me to repeat the designing part, or we go with the coding part?
Yes.
Yeah, repeat, right?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay, let us open the new project window, right? Let's go with the new project. Today lab is calculator design, simple calculator using Android Studio. So we are using the Android Studio file, new project. So empty activity, select basic activity, that is empty activity here. Next, provide the project name. Like simple calculator, simple calculator. Minimum SDK supported by your project is 4.1 Jelly Bean, API level 16 targeted device. Even the low end device also supports this one. Finish. If I am fast, let me know. I will go slowly. Because on the other end of your lab, you require to do. Okay. So every project is a separate Android Studio, right? Okay. A simple calculator. So by default it will have two files. One is activity main.xml. here in this activity main.xml we are designing a layout and a screen. Main activity.java file, we are going to write the logical code in this main activity.java file. Okay. So first we'll design the calculator. See, I'll go with split window here at the right corner, split window. Whatever you do, small changes here, it will appear. Either you go with designing with the design itself, drag and drop option, or you go with the coding option, like coding option also. Okay. See, I'll use the split window for demonstration. It will become easy. Hello world is the default name given. So just I will run this one without doing any changes in the code. See the output. It will display hello world. It will display hello world. Right? So hello world from the top margin and bottom margin, left margin, right margin. This is called a constraint margin. Exactly the center of the layout design. By default hello world message it will display. Right now we start coding according to our requirement of the program. You can come back or switch to the coding window. Simple calculator. Okay. See, rather than going with this entire thing, I'm choosing a layout called as linear layout to design the calculator. I'm deleting the entire coding, or you can use the modify the existing content. Linear layout. So it will expect the expected you to insert the corresponding namespacing. These constraints will be removed. These constraints which will exist in the okay. So namespace, after adding the namespace, automatically the error is it will go. Right. Now Since it is linear layout, it means that one of components which will place one after the another. You can see hello world. Previously, it would display the displaying in the center of the layout, whereas now it is displaying the first position 0, 0, that position. It start from that linear layout. Suppose if you add one more text view, so beside the previous one, it is going to be added. To change the orientation of that linear layout, you are required to add the orientation. Orientation vertical. Now the different text view component display one after the another. You can change the orientation to horizontal. Horizontal means again horizontal is nothing but by default. By default it appears, even though if you are not placing orientation as horizontal, also by default it will display horizontal. But you want to display, you want to put the number one, number two and four buttons one after the other of the small screen, so the orientation you select is vertical. Okay, then after that, every component in Android Studio which will have their own ID to identify uniquely in the existing project, So let us add the ID, Android ID. For the text view, we can use the customized ID number. Here ID in Android, ID supports in a string format also, but at the back end, the Gradle is going to provide the number for that ID. Okay, heading. So where you want to display this heading? At the top. So for that attribute, we are using margin top. Margin top attribute is used to display the hello world message. Okay, margin from the margin top, how many number of space you require to leave? Suppose you want to leave it for 20 space. See, observe the effect is happening here. You can observe. Suppose if I make it as 50 space, see the component is moving down from the top position, margin top position, to which place you want to place it. Okay, if you increase one more screen, see where you want to exactly place the content. Now I want to place at the position of 20th position, but I want to place as a center alignment. If I want to place it as center alignment, for center alignment placement, we are using, rather than text align, we are using it as gravity. Gravity equal to center. So in the current position, that is going to be placed as a center. And so you can specify margin start from where that it should begin. Okay. Margin start, after which how many number of spaces that heading line is going to be displayed. For example, it should display around after 500 space. 500 space, now it is taking us out of the screen, so you can increase 100 space, 100 dp. See, observe the effect which is happening. You can increase, right, margin start. Also you can mention margin end. Margin end means from right to left. Margin start begin from left to right, margin right begins from margin end begins from right to left. Suppose you want to leave around another 100 space. So I am renaming this one hello world to simple calculator. Hello world to simple calculator. See, it is this supports this to support older versions than API 17. You should also add Android layout margin left. Suppose you want to support for the lower end versions also, you can use this margin left. Similarly margin right, if you support it for lower versions also, you can use both start end as well as left right. Okay, fine. Then next, I it is all the designing of the screen, it is all the developer talent or the developer creativity. So how that text should appears. So whatever we done so far, let us see the output, then you will able to understand. You are visible here, but after running this one, how it look like in your emulator, you need to understand. See how it look like? Simple calculator, right? How it look like? It's a normal texting. So to make it attractive, we'll go with adding few more attributes to that simple calculator. Okay. So I want to make some attractive for that. For that, I'm going to increase the size of the text using text size. I will increase the text size by 30 points. 30 is more. 20 dp, 20 points. Then I want to change the style of the text, text style to bold, and also I want to change the color of the text and background of the text. So color of the text is text color. You can use the hexadecimal coding hash. This is very interesting here, hash. Six zeros, if you put the six zeros, it color code is, will appear at the this bar, left bar, gutter. So you double click, it will open the palette based on your requirement. For example, I want to use the blue color, right? Blue color, if you want to use, place the icon here and place the darkness, etc. It will generate the hash hexadecimal code for the color code for the color you selecting, right? So it is applied, that color applied to here also. Now again you want to add some more attractive, like background color. You choose the color, whichever the color you want. When you type six zeros, it will display the corresponding color back here. You select the color which you want to apply onto the background of that text. Okay. Fine. So you can increase the text size. Simple calculator. It appeared in the two lines because the margin what we set is more. That's why it appeared in a two lines. You can reduce the size of it, then it will appear as a single line. Fine. Save it. Rerun it to see the output in a emulator. Okay. Next, if we require to add the two text box controls, what we call in Android today as edit text, and four different buttons, right? Okay. Now, let's go with adding text box window, that is edit text. So layout width is match parent, and the height is wrap content. Okay, wrap content, and the ID for the text is number one. Then then from margin top you can include from where that edit text should begin, or you can just use the edit text. So one more edit text, match parent and wrap content. That is second edit text, and it will have the ID of suppose number two. Okay, save it. Now after adding these two, we need to have four buttons for basic arithmetic operation, plus, minus, multiplication and division, right? To add that one, a button control is used. Button view is used. Button again, match parent, wrap content. Since we use the linear layout, the control views are adding one after the other. If you use the normal layout, orientation is linear, but orientation is horizontal. Everything is placed one after the other. Since the device screen is limited, we need to get it display in a single screen. So we need to have a orientation is vertical. Fine. So your button also have the ID. Button also having the ID. For example, BT1, button 1. Or you can use the button ID is add. Add. To name the button, you use text. Button text is plus. I'm using the text is plus, or you can use add button plus. Then similarly go with button, another button, match parent, wrap content, ID here subtraction, then Android text is minus. Next, similar repeat it for another two controls, two operations, match parent, wrap content, then ID, third ID of button, that is multiplication. Well, then text is star. Similarly, one more button wrap, match parent, wrap content, then ID, division, then text, division, slash. Okay. So let us see how it look like in our output design. Save it, rerun it, and see how it is visible. So it is visible like this. Simple calculator, the number you need to type, some number, then second number. When you click on plus, it should appear, result should appear here. For to appearing the result, we need to have a one more view called as text view. And we need to add the logical code in main activity.java file to display the obtained result. Okay, so this is edit text 1, edit text 2. So we given ID as num1 and num2, and these four are the buttons. See, these four buttons begins from the edge of the layout and end at the edge of the layout. Even you can custom to the size as you decide. I will do use by adding some of the attributes. Okay. See, we can do it using edit text margin start, margin start should be by 20 dp. Also margin end by 20 dp. You can see the effect whenever you are selecting. Similarly, you add the margin start and end for all the text as well as button. You can increase the pixel value for the button. See how it is going to be affected. You can add it for all the buttons. Okay, so we need to leave certain space between the buttons. For that you can add some margin top option. After edit text 1 and text 2, you can use the attribute called as margin top. from the margin top where he want to display. Suppose I will go with 200 is little more. You just under select the appropriate place where you want to start the actions. 40, you can choose 40 dp margin top. Similarly, you can add the margin top from button one is over, then you can go with one button to another 40 points. Again, you can add the margin top for the multiplication, and finally you can go with margin top for division. You can leave the space. Similarly, you can add between the simple calculator text and the edit text, you can add the margin. That is adding the space to the between two controls, two views. Okay, then we need to have one more text view to display the answer. Text view, match parent and wrap content. Text view, you can add the margin top for that, and it will have an ID. It will have an ID. You can use the ID as answer. ID as answer. And also you can use the margin start and end from where you want to display margin top and end, and the text is answer is. Right answer is. Okay. See, again, see the output in the emulator. So what and all we done so far, we just designed the calculator. See, it looks like compared to previous screen, it is looking like better. But the answer is that a label is out of the screen. So you can decrease the size of the margin. Probably you are able to display the answer key is in the same screen. Okay, in this way, in trial and error, as a beginner, what you can do is you can use the emulator to check how it look like, and if the screen size is little bigger, how you can place all those things. You can do trial and error method, right? Okay, stop presenting, go to the window. System is stuck. Let's wait for some time. It is not responding. System is stuck. Okay. Chrome not responding. Fine. So come back to the coding window. Yes. So let us reduce the margin top value to fit the answer is to fit that one. So we'll go with reducing the some points in all the view components, then probably you are able to visible the answer keys. Okay. So to reduce the size of margin top. Fine. Margin top, based on the previous component, it is going to set the number of pixels. Fine. Now let us see how it looks like. It is loading. See how it is look like after reducing some margin top value. Now you are able to visible the whole entire screen. Okay, so when I click on plus, it should take the value from num1 and num2 of edit text, and it required to add them and push that added value onto the screen along with the numbers if you passed. Okay, so we'll go with arithmetic operations. Fine. Now switch to the code window. switch to the code window. Okay, so design part is over. Now we'll go with observe here. All these called as resources. All these are called as resources. Each resources, when you are compiling and running the application, each time Gradle is going to be built. So Gradle, what the Gradle means, whichever the changes you made in the code, it is going to update it to the manifest file, as well as it is going to create its own set of resource repository. So why? Because you are working on single screen now, right? But in real-time application, it is necessary to have to switch from one activity to another activity, one application to another application, again from third party application to the current. Means you want to do the to and fro actions in real time application. So also how exactly it is maintained is, it is maintaining a resource manager. That resource manager is able to hold all the component which will be used in your code. All the components, which are the components here which you used? Two text view, two edit input, and four buttons. See, all these having their own ID, all the views having their own ID. These IDs are referencing in Gradle. You can find the Gradle here, Gradle scripts. You can find the Gradle scripts. Most of the time, we should not touch upon this Gradle because it is a system generated files. If you do small changes also, completely entire project may fail to host. Okay, usually we will not touch upon this one. If you want to control the flow of actions, usually we are going to set in the manifest file, android manifest.xml file. Okay. Fine. Simple calculator. Let's see the label, which label is there. You can even exclude this label. How it look like? You can exclude the label option. Fine. Okay. Come back to main activity. So when you click on the run option, it will call the main activity. When you click on run option, it will invoke the main activity Java class file. Now, what is the content of main activity Java class file? It extends the app compact activity class, and it will invokes on create method. And it also saved the current state of the application with the help of the bundle class. So once the resource is ready to serve, then set content view. Set content, this view is going to set with the current context content with the help of R. R is nothing but here resource dot. What is the resource you are going to set onto layout? Activity main. Activity main is what? It is an user view. Activity main user view is going to be rendered onto the hardware device using main activity.java. Now, suppose if I click on plus, it should read these two values and display as answer key. Now let us create all the component which is used in our activity underscore main. Which are the components we used? Text view, right? Text view component, text view one, comma text view two. Two text views we used. Then edit text. Which are the edit text we used? Number one and number two. Then four buttons we used. Button B1, comma B2, comma B3, comma B4. Four buttons we used. You need to import the widget class. You can just explore. Whenever you add the button, this is going to be imported. Button, edit text, text view, etc., which will be present in widget of Android package. Okay, now we need to collect the value from edit text. For that, so n1 equal to, you are fetching the content from the layout. What is the layout of edit text one? Edit text one layout ID is num1. You are identifying this edit text one by edit text by num1. So you are using find view by ID from where? From the resource, you are identifying that from the resource, the name is num1. Observe here, I told you num1 is the user defined ID name given, but actually internally num1 is stored as a number. You can observe when I press on num1, see, observe the ID value for num1 given by the resource is 100146, number one. So n1 is edit text, find view by ID, num1 is you identified that, but there is a type mismatch here. So to make it as edit text, you cache the whole statement. Now it is resolved. Similarly, n2, what is the ID you are referring for edit second text? Num2. So find view by ID resource dot ID dot num2. Even num2, the what is the value? It is given 148. And again, there is a mismatch in source and destination. So type cache the statement. So two numbers you have collected. Okay. Two numbers you have collected. Next, similarly, how you collected the identify all, you required identify even button also. Similarly, button B1 equal to find view by ID resource dot id dot, what is the name given for button? Button is add, then sub, mul, and div, division. So add, again you need to type cast button. Similarly, copy and paste it for four times. B1, B2, B3, and B4. Button 1, button 2. Add, sub, multiplication, and div. Now, after identifying the text view components in main activity Java, now when you click on the button one, B1, set on click listener, so it should listen to you, otherwise no action will be there. If you click on button one, B1 dot set on click listener, set on click listener of this, the current, set on click listener of this. Okay, similarly, see this is error, alt enter, set on click, you need to implement on click listener interface. Okay, then when you click on button 2, it is also listening your implementation. And button 3, current context, and button 4 is current context, this. Okay, now you are listening. After in the listening, whenever you on click, whenever you do click on the button, that is going to be do some action in on click interface, on click method. So there, since result is going to be stored as a third variable, you can declare that variable. Suppose you want to interact with only the use the only integer, you declare the variable as integer, otherwise float. So float num1 equal to 0, num2 equal to 0, and the another is result equal to 0, right? Result equal to 0. String. Here everything, because it is a Java, everything it is identified as a object of the Android as well as a string character, even for plus. Here plus used as a concatenation operator in Java, right? While working with the addition operator, we need to do some typecasting. So here I am using the operation is a empty operation, is an empty. Yeah, I am initializing initialize state of the numbers, because when you open the calculator, initial state value is usually number 1, number 0, or the result is 000. Operation is initially we don't know which we are going to click, right? Then we need to perform some checking, validation, or you just directly go with the collecting the numbers, that is num1 equal to num1 dot num1 dot get num1 equal to num1 dot get here num1 this num1 is the variable what we declared n1 and n2, right? So num1 equal to n1 dot get text. You are fetching the text from n1. Whatever you pass, it will consider as a text. Even though it is number, it will taken as a text. But num1 is the floating type. So what you need to do, you need to apply the float conversion. So what is the syntax? Float conversion. Float dot parse float. So now it is converted to the whatever you passed as a text value, number value. Now it is accepting as a text, and you are converting that number text to number float. Similarly, you collect the second value n2 dot get text dot to string, get text dot to string. Again, conversion is needed. Float dot parse. So now those two numbers are collected. When you click on button one is add option. Before adding, it should collect the value of num1 and num2, right? Num1 and num2. Now switch. Why switch is using? Because four different alternate options. Switch is used. Switch. View dot get id. View dot get id means view is this. Which view you selected? Button view. What is the button view ID? For example, if you selected the add button view ID is add, the text is plus, right? So based on the selection text, that is going to be switched. Switch. The case is r dot id dot add. If it is the add operation or add button you click, what is the symbol of operation? Operation equal to plus. This is a small o. Operation equal to plus. Once it is plus, result equal to finally num1 plus num2. Once two results are added, break. So we'll go with first case add, then later once we done with display part also, we'll go with remaining operations. Yes, once it is added, it should display the text view. So text view, I am calling it as a result. I'm declaring text view. Text frame means labeling, it will display in the label format. Result dot set text, which are the text? Number one, plus is a concatenation operator. So that's why we are using here operator plus number two. So number one plus operator number two. Okay, it's a concatenation operator to leave the space. So what is the result? Number one plus operator plus number two equal to equal to, so where the result is stored? In result. Where result is stored? It is stored in result. Okay, see, you need to add the some import, initialize beginning, initialize the result value is null. Fine, so let us check first this one, then we'll go with the remaining coding. So run the emulator program. Okay, so present in window. So let us check whether what we done is correct coding or not. Okay, so for example 10 and for example -45, click on plus, so abrupt termination happening. So we need to refine our code. So as a beginner, we are going to learn, right? Okay, some abrupt termination is happening. Let us check, rerun the emulator. Something is happening, that is activity main, simple calculator, null pointer exception. Null pointer exception. Okay, we need to add the another to handle the exception. We need to handle the exception, null pointer exception. We require to add the following code. Add the following code. Public void on pointer capture change boolean has capture, boolean has capture. Okay, v dot get id. Let us add all the cases. For default value it should break. Then we will be back to the again rerunning the code. The second case is case r dot id dot r dot id dot subtraction operation for subtraction equal to minus, then result equal to number 1 plus number 2, break, then case r dot id dot then multiplication operation equal to multiply, result equal to num1 multiply by num2, then break, then case r dot id dot division operation equal to division, result equal to num1 multiplication num2, break, default break. Okay, now here result is the text view, text view of answer. So we need to identify that text view using find by view id rather than null. So find view by id resource dot id dot what is the name answer id number. So it is a text view type. So text view. Now you are binding this message with this operation. Okay. Now save it. Rerun it. Save it and rerun the code. Check with the value 20, then the value 30 plus. See, answer is displaying 20 plus 30 equal to 50. Suppose 20 minus 30, the value minus 10 should be displayed. You can increase the size of the answer to display it clearly. Then go with the subtraction. 20 minus of minus 30 is minus of minus. Yeah, we need to do validation. Multiplication in case of 20 into 30 minus 600. Division is minus. Plus, let's go with rerun the code. Before rerunning, you can just go with come back to the code window. So, in case of subtraction, if it is the case of two negative numbers, in that case you just give the bracket, and for division operation result is division, right? I think it will works now. This is not needed, actually the code is not needed. Okay, fine, then save it. Means whatever you do, you are binding that answer to this. So now let us increase the size of this answer. You just text size, you increase the size by 20 dB. You can increase even 30 dB also. Okay, size and background color, you can to differentiate, to identify that #60s. So #60s, just you can use the background color. Okay, then save it, rerun it. Okay, again now enter some input value. Suppose 3.25, you can input 0.1765, some numbers for illustration. Plus, when you operate plus on this, additional result display. When you operate minus value, it is going to display. When you multiply, multiplied value is going to display, and when you divide, division value, it is going to display. Okay, this is about your lab program 2. I hope you understood clearly, right? What we done is design the front end. Each front end design, all the components, text view, from text view, edit text, button, all having the ID, all those IDs are maintained in the resource directory. Whenever you are writing the logical code using main Java, main activity.java, you are referencing all the basic view components here with the help of find view by id method. So each id method which will uses the IDs of the views. After identifying, depending on the context, which button you are clicking, that button is going to listen you. When you click the plus button, addition will be called and addition happens. Before that, you require to fetch the content from the menu. From the layout, main layout. Then after that, based on the on click of the button, the corresponding case methods which will be called. And finally, you are binding the ID result value by replacing answer text view by the actual value it is going to be displayed. Fine? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's have a 10 minutes break. Then we'll be back and continue with the program. I think fourth program, right? Fine. So in the previous lab, we have done placing background image and displaying Hello MCA in a foreground in green color, we have seen. And Bhushan sir has done that selection of the contact, the which contact you are selecting, corresponding contact will be get display. And this is the calculator program, right? So we'll go after 10 minutes break, we'll go with the one more, that is how you are creating two activities, then how you are passing one activity content and displaying in the another activity, or you are using the intent filter. Okay, we'll take 10 minutes break.